Unlucky! We might not be able to provide you with Peter Andre, but how about this fine specimen of manhood? 51-year-old Tony Reddin. Not only is he Mr. Muscle...
I loves you.
He's also Mr. Karaoke.
Please cry.
The wheels on the bus go.
Not to mention Mr. Bus Driver. And on his various travels, he's become very well connected.
Well, in the 22 years I've lived here, I've met all sorts of people from all walks of life, from the criminal element to the entertainment. Funny enough, just a few moments ago, I bumped into Beaky from Davey Dozy Beaky Mick and Titch.
Oh, I expect that's him now. But Tony's list of famous friends doesn't end there.
I was good friends with Mike Reed before he passed away. Barbara Windsor. Bev Callard. I got a hello, Tony, and I turned around, it was Max Clifford. Yeah, I'm quite well known down here. There's a lot of people on the coast that know me. I'll be very surprised if one of the four in this doesn't know me.
Well, you're one of the four, aren't you, Tony? And last to arrive is Tony. And if they don't recognise his face, they'll never forget that shirt.
Hi.
Hi, how are you?
I'm good.
Nice to
I'm
meet
Tony.
You. I'm Kate.
Bottle of wine for you.
Oh, that's very nice of you.
You're welcome.
Yeah, I don't think she recognises you, Tony.
Hi. This is Marilyn.
Oh,
Marilyn.
Tony, you look lovely.
Thank you very
much.
So do you.
And this is Ben.
No, still not much recognition here.
Cheers.
Cheers. Slancha.
Yahida.
Yeah.
Salut.
Bottoms up.
It's the first night on the Costa del Sol, and Kate Forrest is hoping to get a good exchange rate on that £1,000 prize money. While she gets ready to serve her first course, Ben and Marilyn are getting to know Tony, whether they like it or not.
Have you had a good day?
No, I've had a day from hell.
Really?
Have you?
Yeah, I had some prescription glasses last week and got them sent down from Madrid, got them put in some police glasses. Some muppets only nicked them last night.
Police glasses? Yeah, what, do you work for
like,
the police?
No, no, it's a make. It's like, yeah, like Dolce & Gabbana or whatever. These are police. I'm in a bar last night, Beaky's bar, and someone's only nicked them thinking they're sunglasses.
What's this about Beaky's bar?
Beaky, he's got a bar called The Gig.
Remember who has?
Beaky. Remember from Dave D. Dozy Beaky, Mick and Titch?
Oh, yeah.
Down at Buena Vista. I was on my way home last night, somebody phoned and said they saw me bus, and he said, why don't you come down The Gig for a couple?
Hang on, can you slow up? Because, you know, you're doing it too quick for me.
I was having something to eat, and a friend of mine called up and said, I've just seen your bus parked outside the Thai. Do you fancy coming down to The Gig for a couple?
So that's why.
The Thai? Yeah, Thai restaurant.
Oh, you got a
bus?
Okay.
Hmm?
You got a bus?
Yeah.
That bloody Tony, he is doing my head in.
Enough table talk, let's listen to Tony again.
I was the first one to start doing karaoke in Spain.
Oh, yeah.
When we took, when Freddie got nicked and we took his club over.
Who's Freddie?
Freddie Foreman.
Who's that?
The Bullion Robber.
He's all talky, 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 oh, this and this and this and that and that and that and this and this and this.
So, yeah, I've sung a few songs in my time. Used to be a stripper as well.
You did?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Bit of a Jack the Lad, I think.
Hit the nail right on the head there.
He's done everything, he's bought everything, he knows everything, and he really doesn't want to listen to anybody else.
And talking of bad taste...
I've sent many a bunch of flowers to girls in the morning. And they said, was that because I was so good in bed? I said, no, because I thought you was dead.
That is bloody disgusting.
That was in Saturday Night Fever, that line.
Was it?
Yeah. John Travolta.
I don't care, I thought that was real, what you do. In
what?
Life.
No, no, no.
He's winding me up. What's it going to be like on day two, day three? I reckon I'll have my hands around his throat, actually.
Well, hopefully not before he's had a chance to taste Kate's homemade Argentinian cookie cake with an orange zest.
Maybe she's had quite a boring life and, you know, I'm telling little stories about things that have happened to me and this, that and the other and maybe taking the limelight, I don't know. I got on very well with Ben and very well with Kate. It's just Marilyn I've got to work on.
I didn't have hangovers all in.
I know, so why
I went out on the lash after.
Did you?
Well, you would, wouldn't you?
Oh, somebody ask
Where
him.
Did you go? Who did you meet? I bet you met somebody famous.
Beaky.
Good old Beaky.
I went to the Dubliner. I had 5 pints of Guinness, and then I went down to the gig to see Beaky, see if anybody had any glasses in.
Oh, nobody had.
No. No.